Okay, you guys, so sorry, cut the music off. So in my Facebook group, a lot of the young ladies have a lot of questions about how to ship from home, how to ship for your online business, where to buy shipping supplies, get labels, all that stuff. So I'm about to take you with me. I'm on my way to my local wholesale warehouse in Tampa, and I'm gonna basically show you guys how I prepare to ship. Hey, now I'm here. I'm gonna show you guys. This is the company I come to in Tampa, Florida. I actually just googled like shipping supplies wholesale, what did I google, like in bulk shipping supplies one day online, and I found them, and I can show you guys. Anyways, yeah, I found them, and they wasn't too far from my house, so then I just came over here, and I've been coming ever since, because I used to order stuff online, like Amazon, eBay, which is, that's still good to order, but it's easier. I don't have to wait for shipping. I can just drive over here whenever I need something. So we're about to go in and buy some shipping stuff today. Hello. Good, how are you? But they don't ship, they're only local. You don't need your business license or seller's permit or anything to go shop with him. You can just go in there and get what you need. They're very nice. It's always like, it's an older guy and then the guy that you guys just seen in the video. But I just needed that because I have everything else at home. But all those envelopes were like $20. No, I'm crazy. All those envelopes was just $7.75. That's how much I paid for that. So that big old thing of envelopes, only $7. I don't feel like I could get that cheaper on Amazon. And then even if I could get it cheaper, you gotta pay for shipping. And you gotta wait instead of, I can just come here and pick up stuff. But everything else, I already have at home, but I got it all from him. So you guys will see once I get home and show you shipping. Now I'm gonna show you guys where you can go to get labels. Okay. It'll say two labels per sheet. So that's the one you wanna get. This has 500 labels for $80. You can definitely get this way cheaper on Amazon. 500 labels shouldn't cost you no $80. But I'll come here like if I just need the quick ones, like 25 or 50.
They got the bags
for like $12-$14.
You got me? They got the bags in here too.
Oh, they do have polymellers in here, but as y'all could see from what I just bought, they're very more expensive. Like, let's see, this pack is $13.49 and you only get 12. So I just bought 25. I just bought 25 polymellers for $7. They only give you 12 polymellers for $13. And then they actually on sale because it's 12 polymellers for $16.
So wholesale is better.
You do the math. Yeah, find your wholesale store in your city. Or like I said, Amazon, eBay, you can buy wholesale. But the only cool thing why I would come here and not order my labels off, I like ordering my labels off Amazon. Only reason I would come here if I run out at the last minute and I just need some labels. Or if I need labels printed on. This is so cute. Look at this, guys. It's a makeup business. And see, so what you do is these are the glossy clear labels. What you do is you'll buy it and then you take it to the counter and they will print on it for you. Okay, guys, these are the labels I got printed on. I got 4 sheets printed. Remember, this is the label paper I picked up. Just took it to the counter. See, copy and print center. And now I'm about to check out. Okay, guys, I'm back. So, as promised, I'm gonna basically go step by step. I can't show you my screen because it's a little messed up. Well, not a little messed up. My work computer screen is really messed up. So I'm not gonna show you my screen, but I'm gonna read off and go step by step. So if you log into your PayPal account and you have an order, you can do this with me. So you go into your account, you see everything. Quick note, because a lot of the ladies in the Facebook group were saying they didn't know they had to pay. Of course you have to pay, ladies, but
it comes right out of your PayPal account. So the money for the order that your customer just paid is already in your PayPal account. When you pay for shipping, it comes right out. You don't have to put your card, your debit card, or your whatever, any additional money. Is going to come straight out of the payment your customer just made. You all should be charging for shipping on your website, or shipping should already be included in the price of your product if you offer free shipping. But boost the price of your product $5 or $10 to include it in, however you do it, but it should already be included. So therefore, it's just taking the money that your customer just paid for. So I just wanted to clear that up. But okay, let's go. So you go to the payment or the transaction, whatever it says, on your PayPal account. Mine says payment. So you click on that. My business computer is slow too. It's old, y'all, okay? All the stuff I had since college, my printer since college, so it's slow. Then you're gonna scroll down. You scroll down to the bottom and you're gonna go to print shipping label. That's step two. So click the transaction, go down to print shipping label. Whenever my computer feels like popping up the next page. Okay, so it'll bring you to the create the shipping label. At the top, you have the order details. So for me, that's very important because I do first class mail, not priority for makeup. And so when I have the products, I kind of get the image of the weight. I used to have a scale. Y'all know I'm very honest and I just straight up with you guys. I used to have a scale, but I just don't have time to sit here and weigh every package like I'm moving. But when I see the products, I can kind of ballpark it and guess how much it weighs because I have weighed so many packages already. So I kind of know if it has 3, 4, 5 products, how much it weighs. So yeah, all the shipping details is already here because when you sign up for your PayPal account, you put your information, so it has the return address. If you need to edit it, you can press edit, and it has your customer address as well. Well, shipping information as well. So first you'll see carrier name. So the options PayPal give you is UPS and USPS. Those are your two options to ship with PayPal. And I'm going to do USPS. At least those are the two options on my account. Next is service type. Because I'm doing USPS, PayPal already has which services they offer. So priority mail, first class mail, media mail, Parcel Select ground service, priority mail express, and priority mail service. I don't know why it's like three different priority mails, but whatever. I'm going with first class, and that is 2 to 5 days shipping. Usually my customers get their products within 2 to 3 days, but on here it says 2 to 5 days. It's going to ask you package type, and I'm doing package thick envelope. That's what that is. So I will click on that, and then it's going to ask me my package weight. If you're doing priority, let me go to the option so I can just tell you guys what is priority options. For priority, I don't know, it's not. Okay, you have flat rate envelope, large flat rate box, medium flat rate box, package thick envelope, padded flat rate envelope, and small flat rate box. So most people use the flat rate envelopes or the padded flat rate envelopes. Those are the two that most people use. But you'll know what you have because, of course, you ordered it online. Or you can go to the post office, and literally some days I go in there, if I run out of packages, and just snatch them all off their shelf and just walk out. But they, by now they know me. They so used to me. So they be like, we know she actually using that package, and she'll bring them back when she drop off her packages. But you can go there, snatch a bunch off there. Shelves and walk out, go home, package, whatever. So you'll know what you have, but those are the options for that. So back to me, I'm doing first class mail and I'm doing a package thick envelope. I saw how many products. This young lady has 3 products. I know about how many ounces that is. It's gonna say USPS tracking, which is already included. You can add signature confirmation, and you can also have the option to display postage cost on label. I never display how much the postage cost on the label. For my ladies who sell hair or very, very expensive items over $200 per order, I definitely recommend you do signature confirmation. This will protect you from chargebacks and people committing fraud against you and your company and lying and saying that they didn't receive their product when they did. So when you have to sign for it, that means the post office delivery guy or ma'am sees you face to face and you have to sign for something. So it's no way with, you know, saying you didn't receive something when you did. It's also a box on your left that says email note to customers. I always click that box and I always type a little note to my customers and I just say thank you for ordering. And let me type that up right now. Yeah, it's just a quick little note that says thank you for your order or thank you for ordering or whatever you want to add. It's just that cute little personal touch that makes a difference. So and why I do that is because as soon as you make this label, PayPal automatically, this is also a great thing about shipping through PayPal, it automatically sends your tracking number to your customer. So I don't know, some of you who have already been in business, probably in the beginning, used to go to the post office, right? And sit there, fill out everything, take it to the counter, go package by package. And then you have this long receipt of tracking numbers and then you gotta go home, look at it, look them up, type it, email everybody. You don't have to do that. You don't have to send out the tracking numbers yourself. If you ship through PayPal, PayPal will send them out for you. Oh, the other thing, if you don't want to ship through PayPal, you can also ship directly on USPS.com when you make your account. Like I said, when you order your supplies, you can ship through them too. Some people use stamps.com, but I feel like, don't quote me, but I think stamps charge you a monthly fee. Why would you pay monthly when you could just go to USPS and ship for free? Why would you pay to ship? Or you can ship through PayPal, which is free as well, and it's cheaper online to ship than at the post office. So some people use stamps.com. to me, that doesn't make sense. I never did it because I'm not gonna pay you when I can either do PayPal or USPS to ship for free. So pay them a monthly fee plus you already paying your shipping. To me, that's too much, but that's the option, stamps.com. But like I said, if you don't have PayPal, you have Stripe, you can do USPS.com, ship directly from their website. And for tracking numbers purposes, when you're on their website, it will say, ask you, do you want to send a receipt to your customer? And you just copy and paste their email into that, and then they'll automatically get their tracking information as well. So after that, mailing day is on here. They ask, do you want to add any insurance? And then you go press calculate shipping costs. So right now it's calculating the shipping. I got it. You press confirm and pay. You'll go to the next screen. On this next screen, you will press print. And I usually don't print till the end. I just leave all my, it comes as a PDF. So I leave all my files up and print later. But for you guys, I'm going to go ahead and print this label so you can see. I already have my label paper in my printer. Label paper looks like regular paper, guys. Nothing special. The only thing is, it's two. So you'll see, I'm gonna peel it off. You'll see it's two labels on each sheet, but you'll see. So you put it in like regular paper, no special way to put it in. You just put it in, and then I'm pressing print. So let's wait a minute while it prints. Dun, 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 dun. You guys in my printer? Got a text, bae. Multitask, girl. I'm just playing. Okay, it's printing, it's printing, it's printing. Oh, also, always keep some tape, some scissors in your area, tissue paper, whatever you feel like you need to ship, keep it around you. And booyah. I don't want her address to show. Okay. So this is the label paper, you guys can see. That's the UPS tracking barcode. And as you can see, this side is blank. So what I do, like I said, usually I ship them all at the same time, but because for you guys, I'm not having, you can do two labels per page. I know, especially in USPS, add everything to your cart and then go pay and print at the end with USPS. So you can do like a cart, just create all the labels for all the addresses, copy and paste from your website to the whatever, and then at the end go ship, pay and print, and then you'll have two on each side. But because I did this for you guys, what I'm gonna do, I just turn my paper around like this to the bottom, put this side back into my printer, and then another label will go on this side. the next label will go on the other side. But it's a sticky, so I'm just gonna use this this thing here. I guess her order will be in that. It's a sticker, you peel it off as so, and you place it on. That's your label. You put whatever your packaging, your hair, your clothing, your beauty, whatever you're sending. I really hope I didn't just show you guys this. But okay, that's your label. You put whatever it is that you're sending inside of there. Seal it up. The polymailers come with the sealer. And then you can go take it to the post office. For extra security, I like for my post office to literally scan my items in front of me. You can literally just drop them off at the post office or put your packages in that big blue bin at the post office. You can also, with USPS, you can go on, if you have an account, and schedule a pickup. So if you don't want to leave your house, you can schedule a pickup in the post office. People will come and pick up your items. If you have a good relationship with your home postal ma'am or madam, postal driver, whatever, and they know you have a business, and especially if you're shipping on a constant basis, you can tell them to come by your house, or when they deliver your mail, even if it's an apartment, you can tell them to come by, be ready at that time every day, and you could just give your stuff to them. They'll scan it, give your stuff to them, they'll take it to the post office. You could drive to the post office and just drop it off. I like to actually, I'll wait in line and get my barcode scanned. You don't have to, you can just drop it off. But when it's scanned, I know that the post office got this, it was delivered, whatever, whatever. You can drop it in their bins. And that's kind of it, you guys, for shipping. On Facebook, in the Facebook group, I told you ladies to ask me a few questions and I would go ahead and answer them. So I'll do that now. I'll answer you guys questions. And that's kind of it. It ain't really much else to it. You see how simple that was? I was like, when people's like, you know, they don't really understand shipping, I'm like, what? Shipping's so easy. But I'm gonna answer a few questions from the Facebook group and then I'll let you guys go. So what website do I go to get my labels? How do we get to the shipping label option on the website? Either you can ship through PayPal or USPS.com. Those are my recommended ones. And there's also other websites out there like stamps.com. And she says, how do the shipping label option get on the website? I just showed you guys step by step your options with PayPal. With USPS.com, you'll go to create a shipping label or something like that. Or it'll say print and ship from home, something like that. But you'll see it. So those are the two things that I use. I'm not sure with other websites because I'm going from the reference of Big Cartel. Other websites such as Squarespace or Shopify, I'm not 100% sure how you integrate it. Of course, that's a quick Google search. You can say, can I ship from a Shopify website or whatever? But if either website, Squarespace or Shopify, is connected to your PayPal account, you can follow these exact same steps, because it'll all be in PayPal. So, or like I said, you could just do everything on USPS.com, copy and paste it, your client's information into USPS.com. So next question, okay, this is a long question, so I'm gonna read in my head. Well, I'll read it out one by one. How do I go about distributing tracking numbers? I just told you guys, PayPal will automatically send your customers tracking numbers. USPS does the same thing. You just have to put in their email address. Or you can do the hard way, get a printed receipt from the post office, come home and literally sit there and type and email your customers each freaking tracking number. Imagine having 125 orders and you got to email each tracking number out. This morning was a slow morning. I didn't post on Instagram yet. So this morning I only had 25 orders, which is a great blessing. But like I said, that's kind of slow for a weekend. So between I guess last night, Friday, and this morning, Saturday morning, had 25 makeup orders, which is a blessing. But imagine, even that's a lot, 25 orders and me sitting here having to type in each one, and then you have to find it. It's just a lot. So yeah, PayPal automatically sends and USPS will send as well. You just need to put the email address. Oh yeah, and she says, does PayPal website automatically send out confirmation emails to customers after the product is shipped? Yes, they do. Where can I get my shipping envelopes, labels, supplies? I think I answered that. UPS.com, you can get shipping labels free and maybe other products as well. You just need to go on there and shop. And USPS.com, you get all priority for free. And then they have other things on there like scales, tape, different type of customized packaging you pay for. And then you guys saw earlier in the video, you can actually go to places like Staples, Walmart, Office Depot and get shipping supplies. And then also Google in your town and see, do you guys have a wholesale location to buy in bulk shipping supplies. Her next question, oh, she asked a lot of questions. What is the best service to use, UPS, FedEx, USPS, or a little of all? That is personal, it's up to you. I've always used USPS. It's easy for me. UPS and FedEx are great carriers, so check them out. I know they have specials and special rates for businesses, so if you make a business account, you can maybe get a special rate. So check them out and see. It's, that's personal, but I use USPS, United States Postal Service. How much different will the shipping process be if you decide to drop ship? What will be the process of drop shipping? I will have to do a whole video of drop shipping. So if you guys will want that, leave it in the comments below if you want details of drop shipping, what drop shipping is, what's the process. But basically in drop shipping, the process will be different because you're not shipping yourself. Your vendor, your wholesaler, they're shipping for you. So you wouldn't have to do any of this. Next question, and this is from another young lady. How does shipping labels work? I feel like I just showed you guys. Which company has the best shipping option? I just answered that. How to ship a product using PayPal? I just went through that. And what mailers are best to use for any shipping option? It depends on your product. I think you need to know what mailers are great for your product. I ship makeup and most people buy more than one item of makeup. So that's why I have these boxes. These boxes fit a lot of makeup in them. Of course, they're not together because I haven't put stuff in them yet. And then I have the poly mailers, which I love. You can get those from Amazon and other places, eBay. And then my favorite of all time is the, let me see, can I pull one out? The padded envelopes, but they have bubble padding already. Because I have makeup and I don't want my makeup to break. Mind you guys, I got this big thing. It was way bigger than this because I done had it for like 6 or 7 months. It was so big. For like $5 from that wholesale place I took y'all to. I don't know if in the video you'll see. In the video, like the big ones they have. It was so cheap, all this bubble wrap. But bubble wrap my boxes plus is bubble wrap in here. And that's just because I sell makeup and makeup can break easily. If you don't have anything that can like break and not fragile, you can do the regular large envelopes. Pillow boxes are really cute. It's so many options with packaging. Just figure out what works best for your product and we'll deliver it to your customer as securely, make sure it's safe, and professionally. So next questions. Oh, that's about it. The other lady just asked me to go step by step from start to finish. Oh, what printer do I use? My printer name, oh, look, I got the box. I'll show you guys the box. Oh, look, girl, I got more labels in my printer box. Hey. Okay. Anyway, that was just off track. This is the printer that I use, if you guys can see it. Okay, HP 1056. I bought that back in 2012, my freshman year of college, Black Friday weekend, and it was like $20 from Walmart. So don't feel like you gotta get this fancy printer. Like I said, the label paper, it goes in and prints on regular paper. The sticky part is kind of, you know, inside. And the back you don't print on. So regular paper, that printer copies, scans, and prints. And that's all I needed to do. So yeah, that's what the printer I have, and it was $20. So don't feel like you need this big old fancy printer, and I just got it from Walmart. What kind of paper? I showed you guys the type of paper. You could get label paper on Amazon, eBay, Walmart, Staples, Avery is like the top brand for label, but it's all label paper. It's all the same. I like Amazon because I can get a bunch, but UPS got the free labels now, y'all, so run over there and get it. Just make sure that you do the 2 labels per sheet. That's what you need for shipping. 2 labels per sheet. So just remember that. You'll be fine. And then what software, websites, programs that is needed. So I think I went over all that. So that's how I ship from home. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Any other questions, leave it in the comments below or email me.